for our brother Elmer Wurth, who passed away late last week. And this will be the first actual memorial mass. His funeral mass will be held later on in November, early November. In keeping with our Maryknoll custom of funerals, we will have at the beginning of the mass, before we have the opening hymn, Father Mike Sloboda will read the biography, the obituary of Father Elmer. And then at the end of that, we will begin the mass as usual. And again, we thank all of you who have come here to pray with us for our brother, who served in this parish 25 years as pastor. So thank you. I'll invite Father Mike to come forward to begin this. Thank you.
Father Elmer P. Wurth died on October 4th, 2021 at Mercy Health St. Rita's Medical Center in Lima, Ohio. He was 92 years old and a Maryknoll priest for 65 years. Elmer Paul Wurth was born on a farm outside the small town of Kaleida, Ohio, in the Diocese of Toledo, Ohio, on the Feast of St. Michael, September 29th, 1929, son of Edward and Clara Brinkman Wurth. He grew up with two sisters, Alice and Rita, and two brothers, James and Virgil, who are all deceased. Elmer attended St. Michael's Elementary School in Kaleida, where he was taught by the Sisters of Divine Providence of Covington, Kentucky. Upon graduation from Kaleida High School in 1947, he went to the University of Notre Dame to prepare to coach and teach. While there, he learned about Maryknoll and was attracted by the assurance that upon ordination, he would be assigned to one of the Society's missions. He entered Maryknoll in June 1948, studying in Maryknoll's seminaries in Clark Summit, Pennsylvania, Lakewood, New Jersey, Glen Ellyn, Illinois, Bedford, Massachusetts, and Maryknoll, New York. He was ordained on June 9, 1956. After ordination, Father Wurth was assigned to summer studies at the University of Michigan in Ann Arbor, where in 1959, he obtained an M.A. in Latin and Greek. He also taught in Maryknoll seminaries in Clark Summit and Glen Ellyn. In 1960, Father Wurth received his first overseas assignment to Taiwan, where he worked among the mountain tribal people until 1966, when he was recalled to the United States. He spent the next 13 years on vocation recruitment, fundraising, and mission awareness talks from offices in Cincinnati, Los Angeles, New York City, and Maryknoll, New York. As a member of the U.S. region, Father Wurth returned to Asia in 1979, but this time to Hong Kong to join others in opening a research center for the study of religion in China. He made many trips to China as the country was reopening after many years behind the bamboo curtain. He visited church personnel, most of whom had spent many years in prison and labor camps for their religious beliefs. He was officially assigned to Hong Kong in December 1982. In 1988, Father Wurth began another chapter of his life when Cardinal John Baptist Wu, the Bishop of Hong Kong, asked him to become pastor of St. Anne's Church in Stanley, an international parish with more than 50 nationalities among its parishioners. While pastor of St. Anne's, he also served as chaplain to four prisons in the parish and managed two Chinese schools. He also spent one day a week at his research office and published two volumes entitled Papal Documents Relating to China. Father Wurth continued as pastor of St. Anne's until June 2013, when he was assigned to the senior missioner community and moved to the Stanley Village House in Hong Kong. He helped out at three local parishes. In January 2014, Father Wurth returned to the United States and moved to Kaleida, Ohio, where he assisted at St. Michael's Parish. In 2019, he celebrated his 90th birthday in Kaleida, surrounded by hundreds of parishioners, family members, and friends. Father Wurth is survived by his nieces, Alice Adams and Linda Unverfurt, and his nephew, Gary Wurth, as well as many other nieces and nephews. A mass of Christian burial was held at 10:30 a.m. on October 12, 2021 at St. Michael's Catholic Church in Kaleida, Ohio. Father Mark Hoying officiated. Burial followed in St. Michael's Cemetery, Kaleida, Ohio.
Dear Father McCabe, Father Paul, all the fathers, and dear brothers and sisters in Christ, this evening we gather here to remember Father Elmer, our beloved friend and a good parish priest of St. Anne's Church. 41 years ago, Father Elmer, Father Peter Berry, Father Angela Zalotto, and myself established the Holy Spirit Study Center in the campus of the Holy Spirit Seminary. With him, we visited Shanghai, Beijing, Guangzhou, and many places in China. He had written articles about his experiences and observations of China, which were published in Tripod and China Preach of the Sunday Examiner. His well-known publication was a compilation of papal documents relating to China. It reflects the sentiments of the Holy See toward China and the Pope's call for dialogue. Father Elmer was a cheerful person. His love for parishioners and friends will always be remembered. So now, let us pause a moment and ask the Lord for pardon. I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters,
in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault.
Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, the ever
all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters,
to pray for me to the Lord.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that the soul of Father Elmer, your servant and priest, whom you honor with sacred office while he lives in this world, may exult forever in the glorious home of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us live for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, as I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God. So then, each of us shall give an account of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, the response is, the Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
One thing I asked of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate his temple.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Have pity on me and answer me. Your presence, O Lord, I seek. Hide not your face from me. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Alleluia, alleluia. Then the king will say to those on his right, come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, when the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him. And he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. A stranger and you welcomed me. Naked and you clothed me. Ill and you cared for me. In prison and you visited me. Then the righteous will answer him and say, Lord, when do we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When do we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When do we see you ill or in prison and visit you? And the king will say to them in reply, Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me. Then he will say to those on his left, depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me no drink. A stranger and you gave me no welcome. Naked and you gave me no clothing. Ill and in prison and you did not care for me. Then they will answer and say, Lord, when do we see you hungry or thirsty? Or a stranger, or naked, or ill, or in prison, and not minister to your needs? He will answer them, Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for the least of these ones, you did not do for me. And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, we gather this evening in this parish community that meant so much to our brother, Father Elmer P. Wurth, who is the pastor of this community from 1988 through his retirement in 2013, a span of over 25 years as a pastor. Counting as we do human families, this is a full generation. At the time of his death, he was 92 years of age and had been a Maryknoll missioner for 65 of those years. Of the Maryknollers still left here, I am the oldest in terms of when I first met Father Elmer. It was in my first year of theology at Maryknoll, New York. We had just finished our retreat and orientation, and we were told that there was a weekly poker game on the fourth floor in the only time the priests and seminarians really could mix at my time. So out of curiosity, with all of my classmates who had pennies, you had to have pennies to play, it was for money, but limited, we went up to the fourth floor rec room, as it was known, and as I was a half a corridor away from this place, I heard this loud, bellowing laugh. And that was my introduction to Elmer. And every poker night for the next 2 years before I went on my own overseas training, he would be there relaxing with the other priests and brothers and seminarians, all coming in like Elmer with huge jars full of pennies. Elmer never lost. And sometimes we offered to carry his jar. It looked a little bit too heavy. And one of the things about Elmer, he didn't come just to play poker. For him, it was an entire evening of entertainment, and he was always the center. He would wear unique clothes to this gathering. The rest of us wore whatever we had. But Elmer took care, almost like a costume party. And he always had a hat to celebrate whatever season we were in, whether it was a St. Patrick's hat, or it was a Christmas Santa Claus hat, or an Easter bunny thing. He had something for every occasion. He was noted at the time as an indefatigable mission promoter. These were men who went on the road almost every week, preaching and fundraising to enable our society to do its work. But he most enjoyed coming back to the center and coming to these weekly poker games that were always filled with loud jokes, pretty bad ones, that Elmer would really try to find. He had an art of finding jokes that most people would groan at. But laughter and telling mission stories. And Elmer stood out in our community as one of the best raconteurs of these stories. And this is a gift that he shared with so many over his decades of priestly service, beginning in Taiwan, then in the US, where I met him, and then eventually for a very long span in Hong Kong. The inspiration for this evening's scripture readings and hymns come from a collection of quotes that Father Elmer gave going back about a decade, around the time he had just begun working in Calida, Ohio, at St. Michael the Archangel Parish. And when he died last week, they put out a special bulletin that, thanks to Mike Sloboda, I was able to peek at. And it was interesting because it helped me with Agnes to pick one of the hymns, Amazing Grace, because he said it's his favorite song. And so we honored him with that today. But then for other things, it were little snippets. He talked about his own life and his vocation. And in the first reading this evening from St. Paul, St. Paul reminds us that none of us lives for oneself and no one dies for oneself. We live for the Lord and we die for the Lord. And this is so true when reflecting back over the life of Father Elmer. All of you who knew him, all who knew him, knew that one of the marks of Father Elmer was his selflessness and his generosity to anyone who crossed his path. He exemplified St. Paul's teaching, living always for others, and ultimately living his life for the Lord. Elmer described himself as a hopeful person. He was. And he radiated that hope in all that he did. He truly understood how our lives, again, found in the teachings of St. Paul, were touched by amazing grace. Because he continually lived for others, he could state, "I can't recall knowing a person I did not like." And this is how we come to see a selfless, self-emptying disciple of the Lord. In the teaching of Jesus about the last judgment that we heard in the gospel tonight, we come to see how the way we treat others will ultimately be the way the Lord will see and treat us at the end of our life. Father Elmer loved his priesthood. That's something all of us who knew him understood. He loved his vocation. He loved his call to a missionary life. And he loved all the places where God sent him to labor in the vineyard of the Lord. After almost 57 years of active service in overseas mission, he left Hong Kong in January of 2014 to begin, and I put it in quotes here, retirement at his home parish. But anyone who knew Elmer knew what retirement was for him. It was doing the same old, just in a different church. What he had done for 25 years here at St. Anne's went right away into St. Michael the Archangel Parish. And some of you who have visited him at his home parish probably saw there was little difference. It was the same Elmer, yesterday, today, and always. His whole life was meeting people, ministering, counseling, comforting, assisting, serving, bringing Christ into their lives just as much as their own life stories and faith energized his own priesthood. A poignant quote from this interview he gave some years ago that was printed in the parish bulletin was a reply to a question, "What would be your last wish?" And he wrote this, "I want to meet the Lord with the least possible regrets." Inspired by the teachings of the Last Judgment, Father Elmer dedicated his very life to living out this list that we all know from Catechism is the list of the corporal works of mercy, striving each day to live up to the challenge of the Lord. "Whatever you do for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me." So like so many countless men and women in mission, Father Wurth was given the great gift we all share in mission, the gift to serve. It is a privileged gift given to us, and one that he relished. He served all who crossed his path, from the mountain peoples in Taiwan to the many, many people he met here in Hong Kong from all different places, different stations in life, different backgrounds, to the people he met in the States, to those educated, to those imprisoned, to those in power or leadership, rich and poor, young and old. Each person for Father Elmer was an opportunity, to use a popular and very unpopular word right now, a mandate, not to wear a mask, a mandate to serve. This was how he saw his life, to do all he could each day to feed the poor, to quench the thirsts of those who are of spiritual or emotional difficulties, to clothe the naked, to visit, as he did here in Stanley and other places, those imprisoned or hospitalized. One who, in this very multicultural parish of St. Anne's, welcomed the stranger, and made each person feel at home. That's one thing you knew if you ever shared a meal with Elmer. He made everyone around the table feel at ease and welcomed. Inspired by the motto of our co-founders of Maryknoll, he endeavored to help all around him to seek first the kingdom of God. He accompanied so many on this sublime journey of finding the Lord Jesus in their life. And so this evening, as we pray in thanksgiving for the life of Father Elmer Wurth, let us pray too that the all-merciful and loving Lord, the Good Shepherd, welcome Father Elmer, who has lived his life fully for others. In the words of the psalmist this evening, "There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life." And for this, Father Elmer, welcome to your father's home. Please stand.
God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save his people, living and dead. Our brother, Father Elmer, at Wurth, was given the promise of eternal life in baptism. Lord, give him communion with your saints forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For Father Elmer Wurth, who ate the bread of eternal life, the body of Christ, raise him up, Lord, at the last day. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brothers and sisters, our relatives, and for all who have helped us during this time of sorrow, that they may have the rewards of the goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the hope of rising again, welcome them, Lord, into the light of your presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have gathered here to worship in faith, Lord, make us one in your kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who care for the sick and suffering, that God may bless and strengthen them in their ministry, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the friends and family of Father Elmer Wurth, that they may know God's care at this time of sorrow, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who trusted in the Lord, now rejoice with the Lord. Give refreshment, peace, and rest to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our shelter and our strength, accept our prayers and bring them to the fullness of your salvation. We ask these through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God, for creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, and for the praise of the Lord Jesus Christ, for our Lord and Lord Jesus.
Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that through these holy mysteries, Father Elmer Wurth, your servant and priest, may behold with clarity forever what he faithfully ministered here through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and at your command that we return on account of sin to that earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim
death, O Lord, until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Cardinal John, our Apostolic Administrator, Stephen, our elected Bishop, and all the clergy.
Remember your servant Elmer, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may be also one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name,
thy kingdom come,
thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul.
Thank you. Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation, we implore your kindness, O God, for Father Elmer, your servant and priest, that as you make him a steward of your mysteries on earth, so you may bring him to be nourished by their truth and reality as unveiled in heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Again, on behalf of the Marino fathers and brothers, not just here in Hong Kong, but throughout Asia and the world, we want to thank everyone who helped us to celebrate Father Elmer's life in this wonderful memorial mass, and for especially coming out on a rainy Friday night, which is not an easy thing to do in Hong Kong, especially the traffic and everything else that goes on. I want to thank His Eminence Cardinal John Tong, who has been a long, long-standing friend of Maryknoll, and who lived here, worked here, and knew Father Elmer probably longer than most, and who also was the inspiration behind the work that Father Elmer and Father Peter Barry and others did in the Holy Spirit Seminary, the Holy Spirit Center, not the seminary. And so we thank you, Your Eminence, for agreeing to be here this evening with us, and we will pass on your own greetings to our Superior General and Council in the States. To all of you in the parish who contributed in one way or the other to the Mass, this has been a great way of celebrating Father Elmer's life, and we thank each and every one of you. From Agnes, who coordinated the music with me, Vivian, who did the readings, who is in the office personnel, everyone, and Father Juarez especially, because this gave me a chance to work with him in preparing the Mass, putting together the booklet, and helping everyone. We did use at the Mass this evening Father Elmer's own ordination chalice and paten that when we left Stanley some years ago, it was one of the things we found in the closet. I don't know if he left it or forgot it. I then wrote to him when we found it again and said, do you want it? And he said, no, leave it in Hong Kong. And I did, and there's someone who is the caretaker, and I've appreciated that this person has taken care of this to show their own family esteem for Father Elmer. And I borrowed it back and polished it for the Mass this evening. So this will stay here in Hong Kong as a memorial of his great work. We thank all of you. We invite you to take the prayer card and remember Father Elmer in your prayers. Just to correct one small thing, the funeral, all of his funeral masses are coming. This was the first, and it will be added to his official biography. There will be a funeral at the end of the month at Maryknoll. They have the date, but they haven't given other details. And then the major funeral and burial will be in the beginning of November, and he will be buried at his family plot in Ohio. So he wanted to stay there among that community, and that's fine. Again, thank you. Get home safely. And Your Eminence, thanks again. Thank you to my brother priests, the priest from Maryknoll, Father Sergio, and Father Bruno, yes, sorry. I'm getting as old as some other people, forgetting names, because all of them did work with Father Elmer at one point or another. So thank you very much.
On behalf of St. Anne Church, I want first to the Cardinal to present Mass this evening, and then for Maryknoll, because Father Elmer, yes, his legacy here will last forever. Because every time people talk about St. Anne, always refer to Father Wurth, always. And honestly, personally, I will say, we never able to touch his level, because his motto, like, I won't be friend to everyone, even though, like what he said, when he was a child, he wanted to be a basketball player or even coach, but never make it. But it is in the way how God called him, be a priest, be a shepherd, and again, his legacy here in St. Anne. We now just try to follow his footsteps, how look after flock here. Not easy, but we will try our best. One more to Mary Knowles, who sent Father Wood here in St. Anne. We really thank him much. Thank you, everyone.
Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.